Uganda Bureau of Statistics has started mapping to update boundaries, facilities and households for purposes of establishing enumeration areas for 2024 census exercise. Enumeration area is a unit covered by an enumerator to undertake the mapping. This helps establish new boundaries, created a number of households to determine the number of enumerators to undertake the exercise. Anyango says this makes it easy for the enumerator to understand the number of facilities ranging from health, education, water and population.
We need to get actual factual information. I know as human beings, especially Africans, we have a lot of superstition, we have a lot of fears. The moment they come to count you, you say it's a curse. You know, parents don't want their children counted. Some cultures say you cannot count a man's children. You know, so we are trying to allay these fears.
The authority will undertake digital census exercise to ensure the country database is updated, and this helps to eliminate lies, forgeries, and duplication.
The census is no longer going to be paper-based. Back then, we would send people out with paper, and then they come, someone sits under a tree and begins to concoct information. So you find that the people here at the district, you're saying you have, say, 2,000 city dwellers. But for us, according to the census figures, we are seeing 500. So that disparity is why we say no. Let us go digital.
Being a border city, we have quite a number of urban refugees here and migrants who have migrated here either voluntarily or they're displaced by other factors. For these kind of local governments like Arua City, which receive people from the neighboring countries, I want to believe that something should be done to capture that segment of the population. They are here. Unfortunately, our refugee policy doesn't recognize
Ward Sam Nyakwa, the mayor, Arua City, brought to the attention of UBOS officials to cater for cells that have large area. He appeals to UBOS officials to ensure people employed to undertake the census exercise are paid timely to avoid complaints in their offices.
For us local leaders, we don't want headache of using people and then you don't pay them. You don't deliver what we do. Supposed to be for them, then later they run to mayor, they run to RCC. No, we don't like it.
Charles Ichogor, the resident city commissioner, Arua, is pleased with the digital system for the census, hoping it will provide accurate information. He warns religious denominations that block census exercise, asking them to comply with those undertaking the process.
The technical people who are on the ground, if you get any hiccup from the religious denominations, the pseudo-religious denominations, you should inform security so that we get accurate results.
The first population census in Uganda was conducted in 1959 by the British colonial government and counted a total of 6,702,000 people. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.